please subscribe and don't forget to press the bell icon to get notified whenever we upload a new video.
Welcome back. Well, market's in a fine spot, so let's concentrate on what we should be doing in at this time of the year on earnings. We are looking at pharma earnings now, and joining us to take us through what he expects is Anmol Ganjoo of JM Financial. Well, first up, you know, overall as a sector, is this the quarter when you're going to see much better earnings? Anmol, do you think the pricing pressures in the US have clearly receded?
So, thanks for having me. If you look at the last quarter or the Q4 FY18, I think, you know, there was some kind of a receding of headline concerns on two counts. First was obviously there was a belief that the worst of pricing erosion is behind us, primarily predicated on company commentaries, not just here in India, but also what we heard from a lot of global generic players with the Mylans and Tevas coming and saying that, you know, enough is enough and we are seriously bleeding on the current pricing scenario. And obviously that commentary was further validated from what we heard Indian companies like Sun and Lupin say. In terms of evidence, we haven't seen that pricing has hit any kind of bottom yet. But obviously that remains the key monitorable from a 1Q earnings print standpoint. And second also was the fact that in terms of regulatory compliance, we got some positive news on the margins with Halol and Banilav, two facilities being in some kind of a bother, clearing themselves out. So there was a belief shaping around the fact that, you know, FY18, which was a fairly forgettable year in terms of the whole pharma industry as well as stock price performances, is behind us. Mm. Now the onus is on the companies to reflect that confidence, and we will watch them fairly closely going forward. So 1Q19 in that case does become important to substantiate the fact that the recession in headline concerns which we saw, does that translate into a pickup in operating performance as well?
Okay, Anmol, hi, good morning. The leader of the pack has been Dr. Reddy's. And of course, this fresh news on Suboxone as well. Your thoughts on how that company is placed now?
So basically, if you look at Dr. Reddy's, you know, the last quarter was probably the worst that the company saw for a while. You've seen Dr. Reddy hit for the whole of FY18 by a slew of bad news, not just in terms of on the regulatory front, but also pricing, because we have to bear in mind that Dr. Reddy did face a lot of product concentration risk. At the current base, you know, it does lend itself to a positive surprise. There's an interesting pipeline, Subaxone included, and that is awaiting a litigation outcome. Now, from a reported earnings print standpoint, we'll have to see whether the shipments for Subaxone do get recorded in these numbers. And if they do, then we should see some kind of a pickup. And Dr. Reddy's, because has been probably the worst hit on the downside, recovery in the US, if any, plus the fact that they have an interesting pipeline, should help matters going forward. So for Dr. Reddy's, while the worst is behind, we have to also remember that the stock has moved around 15% from last earnings. And we will need to see some pickup in operating performance, which I think should come through this quarter relative to where it has been in the recent history.
Okay, some analysts have been speaking about India-focused businesses also doing very well. Is that a theme you're looking at? And if yes, which companies would you prefer?
So India historically has always been a superior business, given the ROC profile and the more stable nature of demand. However, from an earnings standpoint, this is not a strictly comparable quarter, because we have to bear in mind that quarter one last year saw the worst of GST disruption. So on those bases, you know, to make any kind of long-term judgment on the prospects of domestic pharma growth would be a bit premature. That being said, I think, you know, we've backed Torrent as our biggest bet on the domestic pharma story. I think this quarter you'll see crystallization of a new base with the Unichem acquisition. So I think that's something which is clearly to watch out for. So domestic business does command higher multiples, and I see nothing except some very, very disruptive regulation from a pricing standpoint come in the way of that.
So what would be the other stocks on your radar? You said that you're very bullish on Dr. Reddy's. You said Torrent Pharma. Any other majors that you think are value for money?
No, so I didn't say I was very bullish on Dr. Reddy's. All I said was that first quarter should see some kind of a pickup from the last quarter low base. The stock price has obviously run up. Torrent is a structural bet we back. We like Torrent significantly ahead of others. We're also very bullish on Sun Pharma because I think, you know, that's a company which has undergone a slew of investments which should start reflecting this year. They also have the overhang of Halol behind them and a very, very robust domestic franchise. So while Sun did benefit from a ramp up in the US, we have to bear in mind that it's still the market leader in terms of market share of around 9%. So Sun is clearly what we like, followed by Torrent Pharma.
Okay, Anmol, thanks a lot for your time today. It was good discussing the pharma sector with you. It's been, of course, the flavor of the market for the last few months. Well, what's really looking good today is the market. And as we discussed, perhaps not the best trade to try to look to sell into this gap up. In fact, we are now almost approaching 300-point move on the Bank Nifty and almost about 75 on the Nifty. Not too far away from Nifty's all-time high as well,
absolutely.
Actually. Ashwini Gujral, Mitesh Thakkar back with us. Rajat Bose is also with us. Ashwini, trend day, 275 higher now. You know, you're saying that perhaps today is a 300 kind of day. We are already at 300 almost now on the Bank Nifty. Your thoughts now, and what about individual stocks?
See, that's the power of macro news. If it hadn't been a macro news, you would be up 150 thereabouts. But the important bit is maybe the first hour move is done, and from here the market or Bank Nifty, while it'll be up, probably will move sideways, and somewhere in the second half the next move starts, because if we keep going at this rate, we'll probably end up 1200 points higher on Bank Nifty. That's unlikely. So if you've gotten in the morning, right now is a good time, even intraday, to take some profits off. But definitely for a multi-day player, this is an expansion that he should buy and continue to hold. So that way, once the Bank Nifty starts to lead, Nifty is also a matter of time before it gets to fresh high.
Okay. That's what I was asking.
Stocks are concerned, L&T Finance and Holding is a buy with a stop of 152, target of 164. SEAT is a buy with a stop of 1300, target of 1365. And SBI is a buy with a stop of 259, target of 274.
Okay, fair enough. Mitesh Thakkar also with us. Good morning again, Mitesh. Your stocks now at 10.
Yeah, so I also have two buy calls to go. Dr. Reddy's is a buy for me with a stop at 2330 and target of 2470. And DCB Bank from the banking lot also looks good for targets of 193, and that's a buy with a stop at 180. And I would like to add an LIC Housing Finance just giving a fresh breakout above this 503-504 range. So that could be a buy as well.
Okay, and we have Rajat also with us. Rajat, your calls?
I have three buy calls, and two are from the banking pack. IndusInd Bank, stop loss below 1935. Target would be 1963 and 1969. And HDFC Bank also a buy, stop loss below 2148, 2185 to about 2198 are the two targets for HDFC Bank. And finally, Reliance Industries. Disclosure has it that I hold some shares of this company in my investment portfolio. Stop loss below 1045, 1069, 1075 are the two targets for Reliance Industries. And unless it falls below 1030, any dip should be bought.
Okay, let's see how things move here. Gentlemen, thanks a lot for joining us with those trades. It's a weekly options expiry, of course. So we have invited PR Sundar as well. Remember, we had invited him 2 weeks back on the weekly options expiry day, and those strategies worked perfectly. That, of course, was on the selling side, option selling side. Once again, let me put some disclaimers on plate here. Option selling is a bit of a risky business, so you manage your risk first. If you don't know how to manage your risk, this is not for you. But if you can manage your risk, in that case, there is a lot of money on the table. Sundar, good morning. So no point trying to sell call options today, right? Because
yes,
the market
correct.
Looks like having a trending.
Yes, correct. Last time I told you our market is like a beach horse. Now it has become a race horse.
Oh, okay.
So what's the strategy today? Because puts are already down quite a bit. Is there any point in selling puts after 280 point move on the bank Nifty?
Okay. People generally say about the stock market, the stocks which are going higher will continue to move higher, and the stocks moving lower will continue to move lower. The same logic applies for these options also. It may be lower compared to yesterday or today morning, but it will continue to move lower because of theta value, that is because of time value.
Okay. So once again, for our viewers, try to explain what you're trying to do today. What is the rationale of the trade? What is the risk involved? And what are the strikes that you're choosing?
Okay, can you repeat, sorry?
The rationale of the trade that you're taking today?
Okay, the rationale
risk,
of the trade
the
is...
The risk and the strikes involved.
Okay, the rationale of the trade is the market has broken out. Okay, 11,000 is a psychological resistance it has crossed. And Bank Nifty, HDFC Bank is doing very well. HDFC Bank has one-third weightage in Bank Nifty.
Mm.
So I was too busy selling only the put options. Mm. And because of the market has broken out, and I did not sell call option. Last time I mentioned, you know, I sell both call and put. Okay, but when the trend is very clear, we take a directional view. And I sold 26,900 put option and 26,800 put option and 26,700 put option.
Okay.
So that's the first thing. The risk involved is, of course, there. I always tell you, when the people ask me, when you take a position, how long you intend to hold? And I tell, you know, when you get married to a girl, how long you intend to live with her? Mm. There are three possibilities. Generally, you intend to live until she expires. Mm. And the same thing here, we take a position of sold put options, and I intend to hold it until the end of the day when it expires at zero.
Okay. Now okay. That's, but for someone who wants to take a fresh call now, of course, we got you now. You would have done it at perhaps 950, 920.
Yeah.
It's already at 9 rupees or 8 rupees, 26,900.
Yes.
Are you looking at selling 27,000 as well? That still has a premium of about 26 rupees left in 27,000 put.
Maybe, you know, since the market has shot up nearly more than 300 point in Bank Nifty, you may wait for an intraday dip to sell. Right. So those who have sold in the morning, you know, the premiums have come down already. But now I feel, you know, the market may either consolidate or may correct a bit. So on an intraday dip, it's good to sell, but not at this point of time.
And all of these are, I mean, all of these options that we're discussing are on the Nifty Bank today's.
Today's.
Do you look at, I mean, trading the index Nifty itself? I mean, are there any strategies that you would follow there?
Okay. For positional, I have a lot of strategies like a ratio spread and short strangle, short straddle, and butterfly and that kind of things. But today, being an expiry day, so we are concentrating on
Nifty Bank. Yeah. Okay. Would you take trades beyond the day, or would you largely stick to, intraday trades?
Yeah. See, I'm a positional trader, right?
Yes.
And only on every Thursday, expiry day, I do intraday trade.
Okay, fair enough. And you don't have to, you don't want to trade futures? You would prefer trading only the options?
Yeah, mostly I trade only in options. So only for the purpose of hedging, I go for futures.
Okay. But today you don't feel the need to hedge because it's a directional call?
Yeah, surely.
Okay, just one final point then. For the put that you are selling now, what would be the stop loss? Because if it turns around, in that case, it can be quite risky.
Yeah, okay. Let me complete. So when I said when you marry a girl, as I said, there are three possibilities. One is until she expires, you intend to leave.
It's 3:30 in the afternoon.
Yeah. And second thing, you know, if she gives you some trouble, no, you may get out. So the same way here, we take a position. Okay, the position is good, you hold until expiry. And if there is any trouble, you get out. Okay, then there is a third possibility for Anuj. Okay, if he gets a proposal from a more beautiful girl, right?
No,
so the same way here. If we find a better opportunity, also we will be closing. Say, for example, today morning I sold 26,700 put option, and I did not expect the Bank Nifty to shoot up so much. Since it has shot up so much, I closed the position of 26,700 and moved to 26,900.
Okay. Well, your analogy is a little biased in favor of you two gentlemen. What about the woman wanting to leave you?
I don't agree with that. Let me put that disclaimer.
Okay. What would you...
And the 3% is up to the ladies also.
Is there any options you would play on specific stocks?
Yeah. For positional trade, I do on stocks also.
Not today, I mean any of the financials?
Yeah, but generally, so let us say I'm taking a directional view. I'm selling a lot of put options. Mm. Okay, for the purpose of hedging, I sell a far out of many call option in HDFC Bank. Mm. Mm. So that's because, you know, if HDFC Bank falls, you know, my put options will be in trouble.
Oh, okay.
And when you decide to change from one lady and not, you know, be with her till she expires, typically what are the stop losses? I mean, at what point do you decide that this trade is it needs to be closed out? The intraday Nifty Bank trade I'm talking about.
Yeah, see, I think I told you last time, this is a probability game. 9 out of 10 times you will be winning. Mm. And so you see in that 9 times how much you have won and how much you are ready to lose. Okay. So normally it's about 2 to 3 times the premium which collected.
Right.
And normally it doesn't happen, you know. So morning within few minutes the premiums collapses.
Okay. Well, then you have to be an extremely nimble trader. So as Anuj warned, this is a trade for experts. That's the caveat you have to work with. Thank you very much, Sudhar, for dropping by. And we will try and see if we can get you again to check out how you close the trades, maybe at end of day today.